From the Ryman Auditorium in Nashville, Tennessee, the country music capital of the world, it's your Grand Ole Opry starring Ray Price.
You and your true love have parted, and you left her all alone. Don't hesitate until it's too late to say that the fault was your own. She's all alone and blue. Don't fill her life with sorrow and strife. Go back and start over anew. Run, boy, as fast as you can, back to the one who loves only you. Tell her that you'll never roam again, and don't break her heart in two. Her, and don't let this be the end. Don't let your pride cast true love aside. Go back and start over again. Run, boy, as fast as you can, back to the one who loves only you. Tell her you're sorry you had to part, and don't break her heart in two.
Thank you very much, and to all our friends and neighbors, a great big welcome to the Grand Ole Opry.
And here to greet you, an all-star lineup of opera favorites like Rod Brasfield, Minnie Pearl, Chet Atkins, Del Wood, and the entire Opry gang.
Yes, sir, Grant, and to just pretty things up a little bit more, I've invited our pretty Grand Ole Opry friend, Miss Jean Shepherd. Well, Sir Jean will be along in just a minute. But we've always got to take the ridiculous with the pretty. So here, under the heading of How Ridiculous Can You Get, is that teller of tall tales from Hohenwald, Tennessee, Rod Brasfield.
Hi, Mr. Ray Price.
Well, howdy, Rodney.
Good to see you, boy.
Well, it's good to see you.
I am hunting me a date with a girl tonight. I want me a date with a gal tonight that wears glasses.
A gal that wears glasses.
Yep, I love to go around with girls that wears glasses in the wintertime.
Now, wait a minute, Rod. Tell me, just why do you want to go with a girl that wears glasses in the wintertime?
Well, Ray, you see, you can breathe on them glasses and they get all fogged over and she can't see what you're doing, see? And even if she did, she wouldn't know who it was.
Rod, I tell you... Rodney speaking, a girlfriend, how's your gal, Susie?
Oh, just fine, Ray, just fine. The only thing with Susie, she's getting too fat.
Getting too fat?
Oh, that gal looks like a bale of hay with a middle bale busted. Me and her was a sparking the other night in the setting room over at her house.
Yeah.
We were sitting there on the settee in the setting room, just sitting there. She was sitting in my lap, Ray.
She was?
She says to me, says, what if Daddy should come in? I says, well, if he do, you just sit still, he won't see me. Just as I started to kiss her, her mommy come in and catched me.
Uh-oh.
And oh, it made her so mad. She as mad as an old flogging hen.
What'd she say?
She says, how is it I come in here and catch you kissing my daughter? How is it, I say? I says, it's pretty good. She says, well, I don't like it. I don't like it. I says, well, you didn't get it. You didn't get it. Ray, I was messing around downtown today.
Yeah.
And I run into an old boy, a soldier, a boy I was in the army with. I hadn't seen him since I got discharged.
Well, Rod, I didn't know you was in the service.
Oh, Flitter, yeah, was I in the service. Boy, I was knee-deep in it.
You were?
I was right where the bullets was the thickest.
Well, where was you, Rod?
Under the ammunition wagon. Buddy, I'll have you know something. All the brass fields was fighting men.
All the brass
fields. Now, you take my grandfather. He gave up everything for Lee.
Robert E. Lee?
No, Gypsy Rose. I'll never will forget the day I got discharged. I took a pair of these deer antlers, these deer horns, and sewed them right there on my overseas cap when I come home.
Wait a minute, Rodney. Now, just why did you sew those antlers on your hat?
I wanted everybody to know I was a buck private. Ray, I was walking down Church Street here the other day just before I took my uniform off.
Yeah.
And I run right smack dab face to face with a fool colonel.
You did?
Well, he was nearly fooled. I looked up and seen all that brass on his shoulder, you know, and I'll give it to him. I slung it at him, Marcy. I saluted him.
Yeah.
He give it back to me.
Yeah.
Took about 10 steps, and he says, "Hey, soldier." I says, "I didn't say nothing, sir." He says, "I know it, but I know what you're thinking." I've got to go and see if I can find my cousin Furman. You ain't seen him, have you?
No.
Now, buddy, there, of all the fighting brass fields, I reckon Furman was the fightingest fighter that ever fitted a foul. I'm telling you what he done. He was a pilot of one of these air dive bombers.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then one day, Ray, in just one day, he shot down 14 planes. He blowed up 7 bridges and strafed about 9 warehouses.
He did?
Yeah, he'd have had a time, sure enough, if they'd just let him alone.
Well, what in the world happened to him?
Oh, they sent him overseas.
Say, Ray, you travel around a lot between appearances here at the Opry, don't you?
I sure do, Grant.
Well, say, tell me, do pipe smokers in one state have anything in common with pipe smokers in, say, another state?
Yes, sir, you bet they do. Seems like a whole lot of them agree on Prince Albert smoking tobacco.
And no wonder. PA is taste-tested and approved by more smokers than any other smoking tobacco. Pipe smokers just naturally go for Prince Albert's natural tobacco flavor and PA's own special process that holds and heightens this flavor.
Yeah, and Grant, they go for PA's crimp cut, too. They like the way the tobacco packs neat and firm, smokes cool and long-burning. Makes for mighty comfortable smoking.
Now, friends, think of the men that you can make happy this Christmas with a gift of Prince Albert. The pound tin is colorfully wrapped for holiday giving with a built-in greeting card for your own personal message. Yes, for pipe and Macon's men, it's Prince Albert smoking tobacco, the national joy smoke.
Well, what do you say we welcome the little lady I told you we had dropping in to visit us tonight, folks? She sings a real fine country song on her many personal appearances and here on the Opry, and also on Capitol Records, and it's always real good to have her with us, Miss Jean Shepherd. Well, you know, Jean, we'd like to say welcome again to the Grand Ole Opry and kind of tell us what you've been doing lately.
Well, Ray, as you said, we've been making a lot of personal appearances all over the country, and by the way, next week I fly out to California to do some more, to cut some more records for the wonderful Capitol folks.
Well, you know, Jean, it sounds like you're real busy. Tell you what we'd like for you to do right now for all the folks is sing that brand new song of yours, real fine one called I Thought of You.
I'd love to. I couldn't say the words he longed for.
dance. Everybody join us in Tommy Jackson, Fiddler Fire, Bojo Park, and Cousin Lou Gilder Cross.
Hey, let the ladies step out and kiss the big grab your hold and go to you. Swing a high and swing a low, grab that gal and go to go. Hey, run, you take the beat back and send the swing your sweet and back to get the beat. What's going back in the middle of the couple?
Hey! Folks, right now, we'd like to take a moment for a sacred song. Seems to me there's a lot of new fine spirituals been written here of late, but today we'd sort of like to do one of the old ones and go way back and remember one that's been with us for many, many years called The Old Rugged Cross.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, an emblem of suffering and shame. How I love that old cross, where the dearest and best are a world of lost sinners was slain. I will cherish the old rugged cross. Last I laid down, I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, I cherish at last I laid down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a
a whole lot. Right now, here comes a friend of yours with something mighty important on his mind.
Well, as an MC, Ray, what do you think an MC should do?
Well, to keep the program running smooth, I guess, Grant.
Now, as a smoker, what do you think a smoking tobacco should do?
Just what Prince Albert does. Rolls smooth and easy, smokes mild and tasty.
Yes, PA is crimp cut, so it doesn't blow around or dribble out the ends. And PA is tobacco as nature meant tobacco to be. Prince Albert's own special process holds and heightens its natural tobacco flavor.
Uh-huh. For making cigarettes, you just can't beat PA in an OCB paper.
Right, Ray. And fellas, roll your next making cigarette with Prince Albert. Taste tested and approved by more smokers than any other smoking tobacco.
Nature in her own sure way put the flavor in PA. Try Prince Albert, you'll agree it's tobacco as nature meant tobacco to be. Well, I think it's high time everybody moved over to the old piano, because that's where Miss Dale Woods is about to hold forth with the 12th Street Rag. We'll be right back.
Meltzer, it's time for all good men to get the track shoes on and hit for the wide open spaces, because that gal of ours is on her way. I'm talking about the gossip of Grinder Switch, Ms. Man Chaser of 1955, Cousin Minnie Pearl.
Howdy!
Howdy!
Well, I'm just proud to be here. Well, sir, I tell you now, Ray, there's a whole lot of folks in town tonight down on the streets Christmas shopping, ain't there?
Oh, I'm telling you, Minnie, I've never seen so many people.
I tell you, the way they squeeze you in these crowds, it's wonderful. I tell you, I'm down there this... I wouldn't tell this for anything. And don't you tell I said so. And don't let anybody hear it but just me and you. But I was down there this afternoon, and you know who I seen down there doing his Christmas shopping?
Who's that?
Rodley Brassfield. And let me tell you what he done. When I seen him, he didn't see me. He was in the toy department, see?
Yeah.
And it is crowded down there. And he pinched one doll, and the doll said, "Mama!" And he pinched another doll, and it said, "Mama!" And he pinched another doll, and it said, "Manager!"
Minnie.
I tell you, there ain't no flies on Rodley. Not since
Minnie,
we got DDT.
Talking about Christmas shopping, you know I seen your Uncle Nabob uptown a while ago Christmas shopping.
Uncle Nabob?
Yeah.
What in the world was he doing?
He had just got back from photographers. He had his picture made.
Oh, not Uncle Nabob.
He sure did.
Well, what in the world would he have his picture made for?
He said that he was going to give it to your Aunt Ambrosia for a Christmas present.
Well, of all things, I never knowed nothing about that.
You mean it's a surprise, huh?
It sure is. She's expecting a fur coat. That's a real surprise. Well, sure, though, I was talking to Uncle Nabob about my brother and what to get him for Christmas. I said, "I'd love to get my brother something that he's never had before." Uncle Nabob said, "Why don't you get him a steady job?" But I'd like to tell all the folks listening in that at last I have found something I'm going to get myself for Christmas.
You have?
You know, I've been having trouble getting these fellas to kiss me at Christmas time, and I've been a-reading and a-going around and looking at all these fancy contraptions that they've invented and everything for 1955. And I've got me something for this Christmas that's really going to get the job done.
Well, Minnie, what in the world have you got?
I got me some guided mistletoe. Bye now, see you.
Well, we've been having so much fun with Dale Wood's piano playing and Minnie Pearl's gossip making, I think we ought to just stay with the gals. Long enough to ask Miss Jean Shepherd out for another song. How about it? Jeannie, what'll it be this time?
Well, Ray, I'd like to do the other side of my new record for all the folks, if y'all let me.
Well, we'll sure let
this
you.
This is a waltz entitled Beautiful Lies.
Thank you.
outspoken or beautiful eyes.
Well, that's wonderful, Gene. Thank you. And if you haven't guessed it already, here's a little Christmas spirit served up by Chester Atkins's fine guitar and silver bell. Much more time slips away, we'd kind of like to slip into a recording we've got on the Columbia label, one we hope you'll all like, one remember, called Please Release Me.
Oh, please release me, let me go. I don't love you anymore. Release me and let me love again. Thank you.
Well, folks, it looks like we'll have to be saying goodnight. But from where we stand, it looks like you'll have another fine Grand Ole Opry visit in store next week. We'll come calling for you in the old buckboard. And up in the driver's seat will be George Morgan, along with the Anita Kerr Singers and Martha Carson. George and the entire opera gang will be coming by for a big Christmas Eve get-together, and I know you'll all enjoy the music and fun. Till then, this is Ray Price saying thanks for everything, and we'll be seeing you next Saturday night at the Grand Ole Opry.
The smoke feels as good as it tastes.
The smoke feels as good as it tastes.
Yes, that's the big news, the exciting news about new king-size Cavalier cigarettes. Look for new Cavalier today in the bright, bold new Cavalier package, a handsome new design in red, white, and gold. Inside this distinguished pack, you'll find the king-size smoke with the king-size taste.
Just light up and draw that naturally rich flavor through the cooling extra length of Cavalier's top crop tobaccos. Ah, the flavor's all there. It tastes so great.
And it feels so great. You get the pleasure of fresh, rich taste and the pleasure of smooth smoke that feels good to you smoke after smoke.
Tastes great, feels great. A great smoke. That's new king-size Cavalier. Here just in time for Christmas giving, too, in a beautiful holiday carton. Get new Cavalier cigarettes for yourself, for your friends today. The smoke feels as good as it tastes.
This program was brought to you by WSM, affiliated with the National Broadcasting Company. This is Monitor, the new NBC radio service.